Hey everybody, welcome to another episode of Blockchain Central. If you're thinking about launching the next great blockchain startup, better hurry up. It looks like the first wave of big mergers and acquisitions is about to start. Before we start, please be sure to subscribe to our channel if you haven't already, and check out our Medium blog at medium.com/@blockessence. See the link in the description box for details. In our recent video summary of April 2019, we mentioned Samsung investing $2.9 million in Ledger, a hardware wallet company known for its incredibly successful Ledger Nano. We also mentioned Julian Ziegelman, a founding partner at TMT Blockchain Fund, saying that a big round of investments is about to happen inside the DLT ecosystem. In this episode, we'll break down the significant M&As of 2018, look into what has already happened in 2019, and see what technologies can be particularly interesting for tech giants in the coming year. The reason behind Mr. Ziegelman's prediction is that big tech companies are likely to start incorporating blockchains into their existing products. For most, a logical way forward would be to acquire existing companies, rather than develop technologies from scratch. After all, it could take years of R&D to catch up with the latest developments and integrate them with the existing ecosystems, gaining access to intellectual property or a customer base, as well as injecting teams with talent are additional factors driving tech companies to M&As. The number of mergers and acquisitions in the blockchain space has been growing every year since 2016. Envato.com quotes the following numbers: 34 M&As in 2016, 60 in 2017, and 111 in 2018. What's interesting, when we look at the most prominent deals last year, is that most of them happened inside the DLT ecosystem. These were bigger, established cryptocurrencies purchasing smaller blockchain startups. A few examples include Coinbase purchasing Paradex, a decentralized cryptocurrency exchange built on 0x protocol. Coinbase also acquired Earn.com, a online platform that allows users to be paid in cryptocurrencies for replying to emails, taking surveys, and completing tasks. One prominent example of a non-crypto company making an investment in 2018 was the purchase of Bitstamp, a Luxembourg-based crypto exchange, by NXMH, a Belgian investment firm with strong ties to the Asian market. Looking at the recent developments at IBM, such as the limited production launch of WorldWire, we could assume that the giant has already invested a lot of money in blockchain startups. In reality, IBM focused on developing their own technologies and assisting independent blockchain startups. They did that by contributing to Hyperledger, an open source effort by Linux Foundation, and encouraging businesses to test run blockchains for free on their cloud. Other efforts by IBM include building a blockchain solution center in São Paulo, Brazil, and selecting various startups for their blockchain accelerator program. So, we can clearly see that major tech players were generally reluctant to acquire blockchain startups in 2018. This has clearly changed in 2019, though. As of early Q2, we've already seen two major moves by big tech companies. The first and probably the most prominent move so far is the acquisition of Chainspace by Facebook in February of 2019. The move, primarily referred to as an acquihire, was aimed at adding talent to Facebook's growing blockchain team led by David Marcus. Chainspace was developing a decentralized application platform with focus on open source and academic research. Another important market move that happened in April was Samsung investing $2.9 million in Ledger. According to the reports, the move puts Ledger's valuation close to $290 million. Although the specific details of the funding were not disclosed, it is rumored that Samsung is interested in launching their own coin sometime in the future. Samsung has another reason to work closely with Ledger. Their flagship smartphone, Galaxy S10, has a cold storage crypto wallet built into it. It is capable of holding Bitcoin, Ethereum, and CosmoCoin, a native app of a Korean beauty startup, CosmoChain. A partnership with Ledger can make Samsung's wallet safer and more reliable. Additionally, inside the crypto ecosystem, Coinbase has been making more significant moves. They acquired a data handling startup, Blockspring. So, what other big players are likely to make a move? We already know that Jeff Bezos of Amazon is a big proponent of blockchains, and his company is offering blockchain platforms as a part of their Amazon Web Service portfolio. AWS makes it possible to build both centralized and decentralized ledgers, as well as a managed blockchain. Users can also take advantage of Amazon's blockchain templates to deploy secure networks on popular open source frameworks. Knowing Amazon's goal of complete market domination, it is not unlikely that they will make some M&A moves this year. Following in the footsteps of IBM and Amazon, Microsoft has also recently launched their Ethereum Development Kit. The solution based on Azure Cloud Computing platform will allow developers to create dApps operating on the Ethereum blockchain. This means that three major IT service providers now offer a way for enterprise users to create blockchain solutions. Another interesting development is that Walmart started working closely with IBM on a food safety blockchain solution. The retail giant will require all suppliers of leafy green vegetables to upload their data to the blockchain by September 2019. The goal is to make the supply process more traceable, transparent, and fully digital. According to the claim by Walmart, it previously took up to 7 days to trace the source of their food. Now, with the use of this technology, it can be reduced to 2.2 seconds. What's more, the system can eventually become available to customers. This could be especially interesting when it comes to organic and fair use products. If the technology proves advantageous, it is likely that Walmart will expand its blockchain operation by making an acquisition. Pepsi is a company that recently carried out a trial to streamline the process of buying digital advertising. The goal of the project was to maximize reach and minimize the involvement of bots that generate fraudulent impressions. By using smart contracts and the Native Alliance token, NAT, only ads deemed viewable, brand safe, and free from fraud were actually paid for. In addition, encryption guaranteed complete privacy of all processed data. The project was run in conjunction with MediaShare, and according to Pepsi's Director of Consumer Engagement, the results were encouraging. One major company that has been relatively quiet when it comes to blockchains is Apple. We all know that the tech giant only rolls out well-developed technologies to the end-user market, so it's probably unlikely that we'll see a customer-facing blockchain product anytime soon. That being said, it has been hinted in the report filed with the SEC that Apple is looking into DLT as a way to mitigate its sourcing issues. The company has been criticized for obtaining their source materials, such as natural minerals, in a less-than-ethical fashion. Deploying blockchains to track the origins of source materials could be a way to mitigate that issue. So, what industries are likely to be attractive for the big tech companies in the near future? Is there a place there for DLT? So far, the most popular sectors for mergers and acquisitions in the blockchain ecosystem are finance and investment. It makes sense, as that's the sector which guarantees the fastest return on investment. When talking about tech giants, however, immediate returns are less of a concern. Industries that are said to be of high interest to tech companies include machine learning, especially one focused on improving customer service. To prove that claim, we can use McDonald's buying Dynamic Fields, a startup based in Tel Aviv that provides retailers with algorithmically driven decision logic technology. If startups manage to integrate the benefits of blockchains into machine learning solutions, for example, by improving data integrity, there might be room for a big acquisition. Another field that has big potential for investment is cybersecurity. We all know the benefits that immutability and cryptography bring to the table, so a distributed cybersecurity startup might be very interesting for potential buyers. Marketing and content in general could also be interesting avenues for blockchain startups to explore. A solution that merges content marketing, media consumption, and content monetization into a completely new product would be equally interesting for Google, Facebook, and Amazon. We previously discussed the role blockchains can play in content ownership and monetization, and the advantages of a distributed, decentralized content ecosystem are really significant. As always with DLT, a lot will depend on scalability. We'll definitely keep you posted regarding new developments in the M&A space. What other blockchain industries are primed for acquisitions? If you want to do more research, or one of the points sparked your interest, we're listing all of our sources in the description below. Before you go, please know that this content does not represent financial, legal, or tax advice, nor is it supposed to be understood or interpreted as solicitation to buy or sell any securities, coins, or tokens. Thank you for watching. If you like this video, make sure to hit the like button and don't forget to subscribe to Blockchain Central to never miss a beat. Also, check out our blog, link in the description below. See you in the next one.